So my name is Barbara London. I'm an associate curator in the Department of Media and Performance Art at the Museum of Modern Art. You might know that's a museum in Manhattan on West 53rd. We were founded in 1929 and we're very much devoted to the collection, exhibition, education of the art in our time. The earliest work in the collection goes back to the 19th century and the beginning of photography. The most recent work would be pieces made, some of which are shown here in the biennial, just maybe yesterday. So my field is video, media, installation, and that's why I especially wanted to come here to Kochi to see the biennial. You have here incredible work which covers very local artists, but you have work of artists from Delhi, Mumbai, and then people from, you know, other parts of Asia and of course Europe. So I was thrilled to see work of, say, Vivan Sundaram, Nalini Milani, Ranbir Kaleka. Exquisite installation with three screens and very, very poetic, very painterly. So these artists have very established practices and a very strong visual vocabulary. And I think the organizers of the biennial really thought very much about how to place these works, how to think of context. And the incredible old buildings, which have their own rich history, are a beautiful context. It's always intriguing with a biennial. Any exhibition, it's a point of view. You can never do everything all in one go. And I think here, having the various sites means that you look, you walk, you take a coffee or a tea and then get another fresh look. The show is large. Biennials tend to be large and we always wish we had a lot more time, but I did sit through the majority of the media work to really see from start to finish, because work tends to have beginning, middles and ends, and you can drop in on something and you get one impression, but when you really stay with an installation, say, then you really see what's on the artist's mind, how, what their agenda is, their politics, and their aesthetics. So, say, an example of Amar Kanwar's piece, you really needed to stay with it, really think about the area of Orissa, what was going on and the nature, and that incredible eye of Amar. It's just breathtakingly beautiful as he's giving you a really strong message.